Welcome to this lecture on Solutions to Exercise 6.2, Question 6 to Question 15, from the book Introduction to Real Analysis by Bartle and Sherbert.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, sir.
So yesterday we did question number 1 to question number 5 from the exercise 6.2, right? So today we will continue on that and we will solve from question number 6 onwards, okay? So let me just share the whiteboard with you all. Question number 6 is relatively easy. So is this whiteboard visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
So question number 6 is relatively an easier question. Okay, again, so you have to use mean value theorem to prove this inequality. Okay, if you remember, we have used this inequality in one of our questions. Right, so we have to prove this inequality now. So how to prove it? Yes, yes, let fx equal to x for all, oh, sorry, sine x for every x in R. Okay, and now you pick any two xy in R. So let xy belonging to R be any arbitrary real numbers. Okay, so we have picked any two arbitrary real numbers, then by mean value theorem what will happen? So since f being a trigonometric function, it is continuous and differentiable on R. So hence, applying mean value theorem to F on the interval with endpoints x and y. Why we are saying endpoints x and y? Yes. We get C belonging to C lying between x and y such that fy my kfx minus fy form which is so fx minus fy upon x minus y is equal to f dash c. So why we have written like this? Because we don't know which one is bigger, right? X is bigger or y is bigger. So either we were needed to proceed like without loss of generality, hame yahan pe assume karna padta, or what we can do is we can write an interval with endpoints x and y. So koi bhi ho sakta endpoint. Theek hai? So this interval could be xy or this interval could be yx, right? अभी हमें पता नहीं है इसलिए वी आर राइटिंग लाइक दिस विद एंड पॉइंट्स एक्स एंड वाई. ओके, इज इट फाइन?
यस सर.
ओके, सो बाय मीन वैल्यू थ्योरम देयर एग्जिस्ट सी लाइंग बिटवीन एक्स एंड वाई सच दैट एफएक्स माइनस एफवाई अपॉन एक्स माइनस वाई इज इक्वल टू एफ डैश सी. सो नाउ टेक द मॉडुलस ऑन बोथ साइड्स. सो यू गेट साइन एक्स माइनस साइन वाई upon x minus y is equal to, now what is the f dash c? It is cos c. So what you get from here?
Mod sin x minus sin y equals to mod x minus y times cos
less than equal to 1, since cos c is always less than equal to 1, right? So this implies sin x minus sin y is less than equal to x minus y for every x y in R. Okay, so this was relatively easier. Yes, is it clear everyone this question? So hame kuch nahi karna hai, we have to just take the function fx equal to sin x and we have to apply the mean value theorem on the interval x y. So uske baad easy ho jata hai. Okay, fine. Now let us take the next question, which is question number 7. So this is similar to a question which we did in our class. Okay, so we have to prove this inequality that x minus 1 by x is less than log x and it is less than x minus 1 for x greater than 1. Okay, so we have to prove this inequality. So how to prove?
Let f equals to ln x.
Yes, let a belonging to a greater than 0 be any real number. Okay, sorry, greater than 1. We have to prove this for greater than 1. So we can take it greater than 1. So let a greater than 1 be any real number. Okay. Is it fine? And let fx equal to log x for all x greater than 0. So a greater than 1 इसके वजह से लिया, because हमें इसके लिए prove करना है, so we will prove it for this. So we have picked any arbitrary real number which is greater than 1, so we will prove this inequality for a. So now what we have to do?
F
being a logarithmic function is continuous on 1 to a. ठीक है, 1 to a कर लो क्योंकि हमें 1 से बड़ा है, 1 to a and differentiable on open interval 1 to a. ठीक है, so by mean value theorem there exists c belonging to open interval 1 to a such that क्या हो जाएगा, yes, f of a minus f of 1 upon a minus 1 is equal to, इधर क्या आएगा अपने पास, f dash c. ठीक है, is it fine? Now what is f of a? It is log a, and what is f of 1? It is 0. ठीक है, and what is this? This is a, and here you get f dash c is one by c, right? So this implies log a by a is less than 1 by c. अब हमें इससे we have to prove this inequality. अब बताओ कैसे लाओगे, हमने पहले करा हुआ है.
C belongs to 1 to a, तो c is less than a and greater than 1 होगा, तो वहां से हो जाएगा.
सॉरी, ये नीचे a minus 1 था, सो इसको a minus 1 लिख दो. ठीक है, दिस विल बी a minus 1. सो अब देखो, a minus 1 तो हमारे पास आ ही गया, इधर ये इधर a minus 1 है, इधर a minus 1 है, राइट? सो इधर a से डिवाइड हो रहा है, ठीक है, और इधर ही, सो राइट साइड का तो इजीली आ जाएगा. नाउ 1 इज लेस देन c लेस देन a, right? Because a lies between 1 and c. So 1 by c के टर्म्स में inequality लाना है, so reverse हो जाएगा. So this implies 1 is greater than 1 by c greater than 1 by a. ठीक है? So now, अच्छा यहाँ पे this is equality. So from stars इस यहाँ पे replace कर दोगे. So you from star it follows that 1 is greater than log a by a minus 1 which is greater than 1 by a. So that is a minus 1 is greater than log a is greater than a minus 1 by a. Okay, so since a belonging to R is arbitrary, since a greater than 1 is arbitrary, it follows that x minus 1 by x is less than log x is less than x minus 1 for every x greater than 1. Hence proved. Okay, is it fine? Yes. So same, बहुत easy है, बस इस पे ही हमें inequality लानी है और इससे फिर हमारे पास आ जाता है result. जैसे हमने वो पहले वाला question करा था, it is similar to that, right? Now let us take the question number 8. So in question number 8, we are given a continuous function with a function which is continuous on closed interval AB and differentiable on open interval AB. And we are also given that limit x tends to a f dash x equal to a. We have to prove that f dash a exists and equals a. So what we are given? We are given three things. First, f is continuous on closed interval AB. Second, f is differentiable on open interval AB. And third, limit x tends to a f dash x is equal to a. To show, we have to show that f dash a exists, that is f is differentiable at a and f dash a is equal to a. So we have to show its existence and we have to show that it also comes out to be equal to a. So let us start its proof. So because we have to show its existence, so we will start with consider limit x tends to a fx minus fa upon x minus a. Okay, or what we can do is we can first apply mean value theorem to this because hame isse is pe mean value theorem apply karna hai. Okay, so let us first now let x belonging to ab be any real number. Okay, so we have picked any arbitrary a. Applying mean value theorem to f on the interval a to x, there exists cx. Why we are writing cx? Because it depends on x. So if we change our x, this cx will change. There exists cx belonging to ax such that fx minus fa upon x minus a is equal to f dash cx, right? Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Now, taking limit x tends to a. So this implies now when you will take limit x tends to a fx minus fa upon x minus a, what will be this? It will be limit x tends to a f dash cx, right? Is it fine? Now, yes, if x tends, agar x a pe ja raha hai, toh cx kahan pe jayega? Cx will also approach to a, kyunki a aur x ke beech mein hai cx. Jab x a pe ja raha hai, toh cx will also have to go to h, so, oh, x. So a. So this implies cx approaches to a. Okay? This implies cx approaches to a f dash cx. Since x tends to a implies cx tends to a because cx lies between a and x. And what does this? This is the limit. Ki agar x a ko ja raha hai, to f dash x will go to a, right? So x ki jagah cx hai, so this is equal to a. Using third. Okay, so this is equal to a. So hence this limit exists and equals a. So hence by definition of differentiability, f dash a exists because if this limit exists, then we say that f is differentiable at a and its derivative is given by the limit. F dash a exists and equals a. Is it fine? Is this question clear to everyone? Yes. X a pe ja raha hai, cx is approaching to a. Now cx approaching to a means it is similar to this limit because we can write y equal to cx. So ye limit y tends to a f dash y ho jayega. So that is equal to a, right? Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let us take the next question, which is question number 9. ये हमने पहले भी करा हुआ है क्लास में, but I want to give you a better proof for this, but the better way of writing this question. Okay, so that's why we are doing it again. So first we have to show, so we are given fx equal to this, and we have to show that f has absolute minimum at x equal to 0. That means f of 0 is less than equal to fx for every x in R. So that we have to show, and we have to also show that its derivative, so f dash x, is both positive and negative in every neighborhood of 0. So we will pick any arbitrary neighborhood of 0, and then we will show that f dash takes both positive and negative value in that neighborhood. Okay, is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so first we will show that this f has absolute minimum at x equal to 0. So consider fx, which is equal to 2x to the power 4 plus x4 sine 1 by x. Okay, consider for x not equal to 0. Okay. So for x not equal to 0, fx is this, which is equal to x to the power 4, right? If you take common, so this is sine 1 by x, and which is greater than equal to x4, 2 minus 1, since minus 1 is less than equal to sine 1 by x, right? So this implies which is greater than equal to 0, which is equal to f of 0, right? So hence f of 0 is less than equal to fx for every x in R. Thus f has absolute minimum at x equal to 0. So we have shown that f has absolute minimum at x equal to 0. Now we have to show that its derivative is both positive and negative in every neighborhood of 0. So we will pick any neighborhood of 0. So let v delta 0 be any delta neighborhood of 0. Okay? So we picked any delta neighborhood of 0. Okay. So now we have to find two points in this interval, in this neighborhood, this interval 0 minus delta to delta, such that the derivative, so f dash has both positive and negative value in this neighborhood. Okay. So let us first find what f dash x. Now, since delta is greater than 0, so by Archimedean property, there exists M belonging to Z positive such that, क्या ले हम, हमने क्या लिया था, 1 by 2 n pi and 2 by 4 n plus 1 pi, ठीक है, such that 1 by 2m pi is less than delta, and 2 by 4m plus 1 pi is also less than delta. Why the same m will work for both the things? Why we can have same m? देखो अगर m1 m2 आता है तो क्या करेंगे हम, m को maximum of m1 m2 ले लेंगे, right? So इसलिए we can write same m also. You can write m1 m2 also, it's your choice. And you can also write same m, it will not, there will not be any difference, right? Is it fine? So kai jagah hum same m likh dete hain, so that means ki kyunki is wajah se same m le pate hain, theek hai, because we can take the maximum of the two. Agar ye jaise m1 hota, this is m1, this is m2, to kya hoga, this is less than 1 by 2 m pi, because when m is greater than this, so this, and this is less than equal to, so we can always write, right? So we can always have same m. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now this, both this and this, both belongs to this v delta neighborhood of 0. Okay. So both belongs to v delta neighborhood of 0. So clearly, xm equal to 1 by 2 m pi and ym belongs to v delta neighborhood of 0, because it is less than 0 delta, and ym equal to 2 by 4m plus 1 pi belongs to v delta neighborhood of 0. Is it fine?
Yes.
Now, so अब हमें बस ये शो करना है कि we claim that कि f dash xm will be positive and f dash ym will be negative. So बस हमें वो शो करना है अब, ठीक है? Sorry, f dash xm will be negative and f dash ym will be positive. ठीक है? Now f dash x क्या हो जाएगा अपना? इसका derivative, so it will be 8x cube, right? Plus x4 का derivative हो जाएगा 4x cube sin 1 by x, and then sin 1 by x का derivative निकालेंगे, तो it will be cos 1 by x minus 1 by x square, right? So if you will simplify this, this will be 8x cube plus 4x cube sin 1 by x, or either you will get minus x square cos 1 by x. ठीक है? Is it fine? Now f dash xm, this will be 8 1 by 2m pi cube plus 4 1 by, या इसको हम, ठीक है, इसी तरह से, अब बताओ व्हाट विल बी दिस. So this is 1 by m cube pi cube plus, when you solve this, you will get 1 by 2 m cube pi cube. And what is sine 2 m pi?
0.
0. So ye term to hati jayega apna. Theek hai? Minus, this is 1 by 4 m square pi square, right? And this is cos 2m pi is? What is cos 2m pi? It is 1, right?
Yes.
So which of these two numbers is bigger? अगर m जो है हम greater than equal to 2 लें, अगर m 1 होगा तो ये बड़ा हो जाएगा, राइट? उस इफ m इज इक्वल, विच ऑफ दिस टू इज बिगर?
वन अपॉन फोर m स्क्वायर पाई स्क्वायर.
देखो, अगर m इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 2, देन दिस विल बी बिगर. सॉरी, दिस टर्म विल बी बिगर because you have cube here, right?
Yes.
So यहाँ पे cube है और ये pi cube है. Pi cube, pi is 3.14. So this, अगर ये cancel, if you take out this common, m square pi square common निकाल लो. So this is m pi minus 1 by 4. ठीक है? So if m is greater than equal to 2, then this is this denominator is bigger, right? So this number will be smaller. So this number will be bigger. So you will get negative 0 if m is greater than equal to 2. So यहाँ पे क्या करना होगा हमें? We will take m greater than equal to 2. There exists m, ठीक है? M greater than equal to 2. ये extra condition लगा देंगे, ठीक है? So we get this m, ठीक है? So which is negative? Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, when you will find f dash ym, it will be f dash ym will be 8 2 by 4m plus 1 pi cube, ठीक है, plus 4 2 by 4m plus 1 pi cube sin, ये क्या हो जाएगा अपना 4m plus 1 pi by 2, ठीक है, and minus टू बाई फोर एम प्लस वन पाई होल स्क्वायर कॉस फोर एम प्लस वन पाई बाई टू. नाउ व्हाट इज कॉस फोर एम प्लस वन पाई बाई टू?
जीरो
जीरो, ठीक है. और साइन फोर एम प्लस वन पाई बाई टू?
माइनस वन.
माइनस वन नहीं बेटा, प्लस वन आएगा ना. ये साइन 2m पाई प्लस पाई बाई टू है.
यस,
ठीक है. सो साइन साइन पाई बाई टू, इट इज साइन पाई बाई टू, ठीक है. सो विच इज पॉस विच इज वन, ठीक है. सो दिस टर्म इज वन. सो यू गेट व्हाट यू गेट इज दिस इज इक्वल टू 2 बाई 4m प्लस 1 8 टाइम्स पाई क्यूब प्लस 4 2 बाई 4m प्लस 1 पाई क्यूब इज पॉजिटिव, क्योंकि दोनों ना पॉजिटिव है. नेगेटिव वाला टर्म जीरो हो गया, साइन दिस टर्म इज पॉजिटिव, ये वन है, ठीक है. तो दिस टर्म इज पॉजिटिव, सो ओवरऑल इट इज पॉजिटिव. सो एफ डैश दिस इज पॉजिटिव, ठीक है. सो हेंस एफ डैश टेक्स बोथ पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव वैल्यू इन वी डेल्टा नेबरहुड ऑफ zero, right? Delta neighborhood of zero. So since delta greater than zero is arbitrary, it follows that f dash takes both positive and negative value in every neighborhood of zero. Is it fine? ठीक है. सो नाउ लेट अस टेक द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन व्हिच इज आल्सो द व्हिच इज एग्जैक्टली द सिमिलर क्वेश्चन. थोड़ा सा बस डिफरेंस है, द सेम सेम डेल्टा और सेम नंबर्स विल वर्क हियर आल्सो, ठीक है. सो इट इज एग्जैक्टली दिस. सो वी आर गिवन अ फंक्शन g व्हिच इज इक्वल टू x + 2x² sin 1 / x व्हेन x इज नॉट इक्वल टू 0 एंड g 0 इज इक्वल टू 0. सो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू शो दैट g - 0 इज इक्वल टू 1. Okay, so first we have to show this, and then we have to show. So we are. So it is given that g dash zero is positive, right? So basically, we are showing that although g dash zero is positive, but in every neighborhood of zero, the derivative takes both positive and negative values. So thus, g is not monotonic in any neighborhood of zero. So we will conclude this. Okay. Although g dash 0 is positive, but g is not monotonic in any neighborhood of 0. Okay, is it fine? It is neither increasing nor decreasing. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is what we are going to show. So, we have g dash 0 nikala. G dash 0 ke liye kya karna hoga hume? Yes, we have to find limit x tends to 0. gx minus g0 upon x minus 0, because अगर ये limit exist करती है तो this will be equal to g dash 0. So इसलिए ये limit से start करना होगा. Directly g dash 0 मत लिख देना यहाँ पे, क्योंकि अभी हमें वैसे तो we know that it is differentiable function, but still you always start with this limit. अगर ये limit exist करती है तब बोलो कि g dash 0 equal to 1, ठीक है. So this is limit x tends to 0, gx is x plus 2x square sin 1 by x minus, और जब g0 क्या हो जाएगा, it is given to be 0 here and this is x minus 0, okay, yeah, x equal. So when k 0 hai, so you divide, okay, you will get this limit x tends to 0 1 plus 2x sin 1 by x. Now what is the limit of this when x tends to 0?
1
0.
ओवरऑल वन, ये तो जीरो होगा,
ठीक है, क्योंकि दिस ये जीरो पे जा रहा है और ये बाउंडेड है, सो इसलिए दिस विल गो टू जीरो, सो दिस इज इक्वल टू 0.1। ठीक है, इज इट फाइन? इसको प्रूव भी करते हैं हम, इफ यू रिमेंबर x sin 1 by x minus 0, सो इसको लिखते हैं हम x sin 1 by x, सो व्हिच इज लेस देन इक्वल टू मॉड x, राइट? रिमेंबर?
यस सर।
तो इस तरह से हम प्रूव भी करते हैं। सो हेंस बाय डेफिनेशन ऑफ डिफरेंशिएबिलिटी g dash 0 is equal to 1, so which is greater than 0, okay? But we will show that it is not monotonic in this interval. So although derivative at this point is positive, but it is still not monotonic in the neighborhood of 0. So let delta greater than 0 be any real number, okay? So we will pick any neighborhood of, so let delta greater than 0 be any real number. Okay, now by Archimedean property, there exists M, okay, belonging to Z positive. So again, we can take M to be greater than or equal to 2. अभी देख लेंगे इस पे क्या condition आएगी, such that यहाँ पे भी same ही काम करेगा. 1 by 2 M pi is less than डेल्टा एंड या इस, ठीक है, बेसिकली हम इस फॉर्म में क्यों ले रहे हैं, देखो ये एक तो 2m pi ले रहे हैं, सो इससे क्या होगा कि सारे जीरो, वो एक जीरो, पहले चलो निकाल लेते हैं डेरिवेटिव, देन यू विल अंडरस्टैंड कि व्हाई वी आर टेकिंग दिस, ठीक है? सो फर्स्ट लेट अस जस्ट फाइंड द डेरिवेटिव. नाउ g dash x क्या होगा अपना, when x is not equal to 0, इसका डेरिवेटिव 1 plus
4x into sin 1 by x,
sin 1 by x plus 2x square cos 1 by x into
minus 1 by x square,
minus 1 by x square. So this is 1 plus 4x sin 1 by x minus 2 cos 1 by x, ठीक है? तो जब नेगेटिव लाना है तो हमें क्या करना होगा, ये 1 होना चाहिए, ये 0 होना चाहिए, ठीक है? तो नेगेटिव आ जाएगा, ठीक है, क्योंकि ये 1 है, सो और जब पॉजिटिव लाना है तो क्या करेंगे, इसको 1 कर देंगे, इसको 0 कर देंगे, सो वही मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव है, ठीक है? सो ये 1 कब होगा, सॉरी ये जीरो कब होगा, जब हमारा 2 पाई की फॉर्म का होगा नंबर, 2 मतलब जीरो होगा या 2 2m पाई की फॉर्म का होगा, राइट?
यस सर।
और इस पे ये अपना 1 हो जाता है, ठीक है, क्योंकि वी वांट इट टू बी 1, वी डोंट वांट इट टू बी -1, ठीक है, इसलिए हम 2m पाई ले रहे हैं, हम पाई नहीं ले रहे हैं, m पाई नहीं ले रहे हैं, m पाई लेने से क्या होगा, ये अपना माइनस वन, सॉरी ये तो जीरो हो जाएगा, बट दिस विल बी -1, राइट? सो ये प्रॉब्लम कर देगा, सो बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट इट टू बी नेगेटिव, सो हमें क्या करना होगा, वी हैव टू टेक इन दिस फॉर्म, सो इसलिए हम x को 1/2mπ लेते हैं, ठीक है? और अब नेक्स्ट में क्या करना है, वी वॉन्ट इट टू बी जीरो एंड दिस टू बी पॉजिटिव, और ये पॉजिटिव कब होता है, जब ये हमारा इसी फॉर्म का हो, 4m + 1π/2 की फॉर्म का हो, ठीक है, तभी ये पॉजिटिव होता है और ये जीरो होता है, ठीक है? अदरवाइज अगर ये 2m + 1π/2 की फॉर्म का है तो कुछ ऑड पे ये 1 हो जाएगा, कुछ ऑड पे -1 हो जाएगा, राइट? जैसे अगर 3π/2 है तो उस पे नेगेटिव हो जाएगा, और पाई बाई टू है तो उस पे पॉजिटिव हो जाएगा, या 5π/2 है तो उस पे पॉजिटिव हो जाएगा, सो बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट इट टू बी पॉजिटिव, ऑलवेज पॉजिटिव, सो वी विल हैव टू टेक x, ये 1/x इन दिस फॉर्म, सो इसलिए हम ये दोनों नंबर लेते हैं, ठीक है? इज इट क्लियर नाउ? सो नाउ Now let, चलो वो मैं पेस्ट ही कर देता हूँ. So let delta greater than 0 be any real number. So by Archimedean property, we have this. ठीक है, यहाँ पे तो वन ही है तो हमें कुछ ज्यादा करने की जरूरत भी नहीं है, एक को जीरो एक को वो करना होगा, बस सिंपली हो जाएगा अपना। सो 1/2 m π व्हेन दिस इज लेस देन डेल्टा एंड 2/4 m + 1 π इज आल्सो लेस देन डेल्टा। ठीक है, नाउ सो क्लियरली सो देन xm इक्वल टू 1/2 m π एंड ym इक्वल टू 2/4 m + 1 π, सो बोथ आर मेंबर्स ऑफ v डेल्टा जीरो, डेल्टा नेबरहुड ऑफ जीरो, राइट। f डैश xm इज इक्वल टू व्हाट इज दिस, इट इज 1 + 4 × 1/2 m π साइन 2 m π माइनस 2 cos 2 m π, ठीक है, सो विच इज क्या रहा है 1 माइनस, बिकॉज दिस इज 0 इट इज 1, सो 1 माइनस 2 विच इज इक्वल टू माइनस 1 विच इज लेस देन 0, राइट। एंड f डैश ym इज इक्वल टू 1 + 4 × 2/4 m + 1 π साइन 4 m + 1 π/2, माइनस 2 cos 4 m + 1 π/2। अब पाई बाई टू फॉर्म पे कॉस जीरो होता है एंड बिकॉज ये 4 m + 1 की फॉर्म का है सो दिस विल बी 1, सो वी गेट 1 + 8/4 m + 1 π विच इज ग्रेटर देन 0, सो हेंस f dash takes both positive and negative values in v delta neighborhood of 0. Now since delta greater than 0 is arbitrary, it follows that f dash takes both positive and negative values in every neighborhood of 0. Consequently, sorry, f dash nahi, sab jagah g dash hai, theek hai, because it was our function g. ठीक है, it is everywhere g dash. So g dash takes, hence g is not monotonic in any neighborhood of 0, क्योंकि दोनों ही वैल्यूज हो रही है तो मोनोटोनिक हो नहीं सकता। मोनोटोनिक होने के लिए या तो पॉजिटिव होना चाहिए या नेगेटिव होना चाहिए इन एन इंटरवल, राइट। सो हेंस प्रूव्ड। ठीक है, इज इट फाइन एवरीवन दिस क्वेश्चन?
यस सर।
ओके, नाउ वी हैव टू गिव एन एग्जांपल ऑफ अ कंटीन्यूअस फंक्शन, यूनिफॉर्मली कंटीन्यूअस फंक्शन ऑन क्लोज इंटरवल 0 1 दैट इज डिफरेंशिएबल ऑन ओपन इंटरवल 0 1 बट हुज डेरिवेटिव इज अनबाउंडेड। Give an example of a uniformly continuous function on closed interval 0, 1 which has to be differentiable on open interval 0, 1 but uska derivative hai jo wo unbounded hona chahiye. Kaun sa aisa function hoga? Unbounded hone ke liye jo hai x hamara denominator mein hona chahiye kyunki 0 hai na yahan pe, so x denominator mein hona chahiye, derivative ke x derivative mein x denominator mein hona chahiye. So dekho, uniformly continuous on closed and bounded interval chahiye to koi bhi continuous function le sakte ho. You can pick any continuous function because every continuous function defined on a closed and bounded interval is uniformly continuous. So हमें कोई भी continuous function लेना है जो differentiable भी हो और जिसका differentiation करने पे x जो है वो denominator में आ जाए। कौन सा ऐसा function होता है?
Polynomial function.
कौन सा जिसका डेरिवेटिव में एक्स डिनोमिनेटर में आ जाए।
वन अपॉन एक्स स्क्वायर या वन अपॉन एक्स,
नहीं तो वो तो वो यूनिफॉर्मली कंटिन्यूस कहाँ होता है जीरो वन पे, वो तो अनबाउंडेड हो जाता है जीरो वन पे। जीरो पे कंटिन्यूस नहीं होता ना वन बाई एक्स स्क्वायर। ऐसा कोई फंक्शन नहीं हुआ जो जिसमें जो अनबाउंडेड हो इस पे ना, तो ऊपर एक्स हो लेकिन बाद में नीचे हो जाए एक्स, कौन सा होता है?
log x
रूट एक्स। log x जो है log जीरो पे डिफाइंड नहीं है ना, इट इज डिफाइंड ऑन पॉजिटिव नंबर्स राइट, इस पे डिफाइंड है, वो जीरो पे नहीं डिफाइंड है ठीक है, log x भी नहीं ले सकते ठीक है, इज इट फाइन?
यस।
So fx equal to root x, so then we know that f is uniformly continuous on closed interval 0 1, being a continuous function on closed interval 0 1, right? Being a continuous function on closed interval 0 1, and also f is differentiable on open interval 0 1 and f dash x is equal to 1 by 2 root x, right? For all x belonging to 0, 1. So clearly, f dash is unbounded. Yeah, isko is tarah se likh sakte ho. So since limit x tends to 0 positive, f dash x approaches to plus infinity. So hence, f dash is unbounded on. Is it fine? Yes.
Yes.
Is it clear, everyone?
Yes.
ये क्वेश्चन हमने करा हुआ है, नेक्स्ट वाला दिस वी हैव डन इन द क्लास, दिस इज एन एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डाबॉक्स थ्योरम राइट। So we are given a function h where hx is equal to 0 when x is less than 0 and hx equal to 1 for x greater than or equal to 0. So we have to prove there does not exist a function f such that f dash x equal to hx. So इसके लिए क्या करेंगे हम? Yes, we will assume suppose there exists a function f from R to R such that f dash x is equal to hx right for all x in R. Now since h of minus 1 is less than 0, वो 1 by 2 ले लेंगे value, क्योंकि 0 और 1 पे value आ रही है, दो values आ रही है, so we will take 1 by 2 the number in between which is not covered. So 1 by 2 is less than h of 1, so by mean value theorem, oh sorry, by Darboux theorem, which is an intermediate value theorem for derivatives. Okay, so this implies your f dash minus 1 is less than 1 by 2 is less than f dash 1 because f dash is equal to hx. So by Darboux theorem, which is an intermediate mean value theorem for there exists c belonging to minus 1 to 1 such that f dash c is equal to 1 by 2, that is h of c is equal to 1 by 2, which is a contradiction because h takes only two values, right? So first part we have done. Okay, now we have to give two examples. Kaun se do examples lete humne, if you remember? दो एग्जाम्पल, जी वन एक्स इक्वल टू एक्स इफ एक्स इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू जीरो, हमें जीरो पे डिफाइन नहीं करना है इसे, एंड जीरो इफ एक्स इज लेस देन जीरो, देन जी डैश एक्स इज इक्वल टू वन इफ एक्स इज ग्रेटर देन जीरो एंड जीरो इफ एक्स इज लेस देन जीरो। which is equal to hx for all x not equal to 0, right? ये g1 हो गया अपना, ठीक है? अब g2 क्या डिफाइन करना है? So we have to define another function g2 that should not differ by g1 by a constant, ठीक है? So constant से differ नहीं होना चाहिए, लेकिन hx को इंटीग्रेट करेंगे तो क्या आएगा? hx जो है यहाँ पे 1 है, so इसको इंटीग्रेट करोगे तो x plus some constant आएगा और इधर it will be 0, ठीक है? मतलब इसको इंटीग्रेट करोगे तो कोई कांस्टेंट आएगा, 0 plus some constant. So ये यहाँ पे क्या करेंगे हम, इन ये जो दो कांस्टेंट है ये इनको चेंज कर देंगे, सो दैट द डिफरेंस विल नॉट बी अ कांस्टेंट. सो विल टेक g2x इक्वल टू x plus 2 इफ x इज ग्रेटर देन 0. अब क्या करना है, डिफरेंस को वी हैव टू, सो यहाँ पे डिफरेंस 2 आ रहा है, सो इसको जो है, इसका डिफरेंस जो है वी कैन टेक सम अदर नंबर, सो वी कैन टेक 3 इफ x इज लेस देन 0. सो यू कैन टेक एनी नंबर अदर देन 2, देन g2x, g2 dash x is also equal to hx for all x not equal to 0. Also, g1 minus g2 is not a constant function. Why it is not a constant function? Because agar g1 minus g2 x 1 loge to kya aega? G1 minus G2 will be 1 will be 2 and G1 minus G2 minus 1 will be 3. So not constant, two different values, right? G1 minus G2 ki two different values, so it is not a constant function. So this completes our question number 13. Oh sorry, 12. So we have 5 minutes, so we can do one more question. So question number 13. So it is just we are given f dash to be strictly greater than 0. We have to show that f is strictly increasing. So you will apply mean value theorem, right? कोई भी क्या करोगे, pick any two, let x y belonging to I be any two real numbers, ठीक है? X one x two बल्कि ये ले लो, क्योंकि strictly increasing show करना है, तो you can pick any, let x one x two be any two. X1, X2 be any two real numbers with X1 less than X2. ठीक है, हमें शो करना है कि fx1 is strictly less than fx2 because we have to show f is strictly increasing. Now apply mean value theorem to f on X1, X2. इस interval पे apply करोगे तो you will get fx2 minus fx1 upon X2 minus X1 equal to f dash c. Now f is positive, so this is greater than 0, right? So this implies fx2 minus fx1 upon x2 minus x1 is greater than 0. Now denominator is always already positive, so this implies fx2 minus fx1 is greater than 0, and this implies your fx2 is greater than fx1. Hence f is increasing on I. Is it fine? Is it fine, everyone? So इस तरह से कर सकते हो. Then next question is same. अब यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा slightly difference है. इसका proof जल्दी से बताओ तुम लोग. So just read the question and give me its answer. So I is any interval, f is differentiable on I. We are given that f dash is never zero on I. That is, the function does not take zero. The derivative does not take the value zero on I. So we have to show that either it is positive or it is negative. It cannot be both. F dash cannot take both values on, both positive and negative values on I. Why? How you will prove it? Use Darboux's theorem here. Okay? Okay? So we have to show that it is always positive or always negative. So without loss of, so what we can do is, suppose on the contrary, there exist a, b belonging to I such that f dash a is negative and f dash b is positive. मतलब एक negative value ले रहा है, एक positive value ले रहा है, क्योंकि हमें show करना है कि या तो हमेशा ही positive है या हमेशा ही negative है. So we are assuming, suppose ऐसा नहीं है, so we will have two points at at one point we will have negative value, at other point we will have positive value. Then by Darboux theorem, what will happen? There exists C lying between A and B such that f dash C will be 0, because 0 lies between f dash A and f dash B. So by Darboux theorem, we will have this. Darboux theorem is intermediate value theorem. Now 0 is lying between f dash A and f dash B. So there will exist some C lying between A and B such that f dash A is equal to 0. So this implies, which is a contradiction. Why it is a contradiction? Because we are given that f dash never vanishes on 0. To the given fact that f dash never 0 on I. ठीक है, बट ये C एक I में नंबर मिल रहा है जो 0 है. सो ये हमारे कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन है. ठीक है, इज इट फाइन? क्लियर एवरीवन?
यस सर.
चलो लास्ट क्वेश्चन करते हैं आज का, देन वी विल एंड. सो that I be an interval, prove that if f is differentiable on I and f dash is bounded, then f satisfies Lipschitz condition. So we are given f is differentiable on I, and second we are given that f dash is bounded on I. So what will happen? We have to show f satisfies Lipschitz condition. To show, there exists k greater than 0 says that fx minus fy is less than k times mod x minus y for all xy belonging to I. So how you will prove it? Yes. So इसको मीन वैल्यू थ्योरम से कर दोगे. ठीक है, सो फर्स्ट f dash इज बाउंडेड. सो सिंस f dash इज bounded on I, so there exists k greater than 0 such that f dash x is less than equal to k for all x belonging to I, right? क्योंकि bounded है तो ऐसा एक number k मिल जाएगा हमें, right? Now let x y belonging to I be any two real numbers. So we are picking any two arbitrary real numbers in I. ठीक है, so we picked. Now apply mean value theorem to the interval, close interval, close to the close interval I with end points to f on I, to f on close interval I with end points x and y. क्योंकि हमें पता नहीं है कौन सा बड़ा है कौन सा छोटा है, so we can say we are taking the interval, so I can be either xy or it can be yx. ठीक है, so there exists C lying between x and y, C lying between x, yeah, C belonging to y, C lying between x and y is better, such that क्या हो जाएगा, fx minus fy फॉर्म में ले लेते हैं. fx minus fy upon x minus y is equal to f dash c. Now take the modulus on both sides. ये same जो sine वाला जो question कर रहा था उसी की तरह है same. क्योंकि वो भी bounded था ना, so ये property आ जाती है वहाँ से bounded के वजह से. ठीक है, वहाँ पे one bound क्या था, one था, यहाँ पे ये अपना. So this is fx minus fy less than equal to k times x minus y, because this is less than equal to k. ठीक है, so इससे आ गया. Is it fine?
Yes.
Yes, is it fine? Yes.
Yes, sir.
So हमने ये सारे questions कर लिए हैं. ठीक है, एक बार roughly देख लेते हैं क्या क्या करा है किस किस question में, so that you remember. एक बार roughly discuss कर लेते हैं जल्दी से. So if you look at the sixth question, जो अभी हमने Lipschitz की तरह करा है, because हमने यहाँ पे ये cos c less than equal to, so we applied mean value theorem and then we use this fact that cos c is less than equal to 1 to get this. then this, इसके लिए हमने mean value theorem apply करा log x पे on the interval 1 to a, ठीक है, and then we use this fact that because c lies between, so 1 is less than c, less than a, so 1 by, so 1 is greater than 1 by c, 1 by a, and then we substituted the values, ठीक है, इस question में क्या करा था हमने, because we have to show f dash a exists and equals a, so we started with the definition of f dash a, so we started with limit x tends to a and then we made the necessary substitutions, ठीक है, mean value theorem apply करके, और ये तो अभी ये हम दो बार कर चुके हैं ये क्वेश्चन, एंड दिस क्वेश्चन इज आल्सो सिमिलर टू दिस, यहाँ पे x x m को 1 by 2 m pi एंड y m को 2 by 4 m plus 1 pi, right? Then next 5 questions, इसमें क्या करा है हमने, इनमें बाकी तो सिंपल है. So if you look at this, so इसमें क्या करा था हमने, रूट एक्स, राइट, यूनिफॉर्मली कंटिन्यूस फंक्शन, और इसमें वी यूज डाबॉक्स थ्योरम, एप्लीकेशन और डाबॉक्स थ्योरम, राइट, इसमें भी डाबॉक्स थ्योरम, देन यहाँ पे हमने वो प्रूफ इंक्रीजिंग वाले का प्रूफ इमिटेट कर दिया था, बस यहाँ पे स्ट्रिक्टली है, तो क्योंकि पॉजिटिव है तो ग्रेटर देन जीरो आ जाएगा, तो स्ट्रिक्टली आ जाएगा, सो उससे स्ट्रिक्टली आ गया था, एंड देन हेयर वी अप्लाई डाबॉक्स थ्योरम, ठीक है, इसमें 14th में भी डाबॉक्स थ्योरम अप्लाई कर दिया, एंड 15th तो अभी कराई है सेम, ठीक है, सो किसी को कोई डाउट इन क्वेश्चन में से? यस
नो सर.
ओके, सो ये क्वेश्चंस दोबारा खुद से भी प्रैक्टिस कर लेना, सो दैट तुम इजीली कर पाओ बाद में कभी भी, ठीक है, अभी क्योंकि इट इज फ्रेश टू यू ऑल, सो यू कैन ट्राई इट वंस ऑन योर ओन, इसका खुद से प्रूफ लिखने की कोशिश करना. So now I am ending this class. Okay. So bye everyone. Have a good day.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for watching this video. To stay updated, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Cosmos Learning. Happy learning through Cosmos Learning. To watch more, click on any of these cards. Thank you once again.